Hello everyone, my name is Raman. In the last two videos I showed you how to attack on the king side and in this video I want to show you how to play on the queen side. So this is a position from King's Indian Defense as so the main ideas of our white will be to play on the queen side. And black will try to play on the king side. So yeah, this is a game of Rainier, which who played we saw in his first video we saw him winning, and in the second video he lost to Gatakamsky, and now we are seeing him on the winning side. So yeah, so what do you think is the best move here, whether to play b4 or first play rook b1 and then prepare preparing b4 by playing rook b1. What do you think? So here rook b1 is a good move. So why rook b1 is a good move, and why not b4? If b4, then simple a5 and you will lose the control of the c5 square. That's important thing. That's the reason rook b1 is an important move. After knight h7, if black tries to stop the aid of b4 with a5, then a3 simple a3 and that doesn't change much. So I think it's better to play knight h7, and since he has to seek his own counterplay, and also note that don't try to make any pawn moves where you are on the side of the wing where you are weak or where your opponent is playing. For example, white is playing on the queen side, so it's better not to play a5 because it only weakens your position and it only accelerates his attack. So just try to avoid, it's general principle, but even principles need to be violated, so remember one thing. So b4, continuing with his queen side attack, and a5, a3, a takes b4. Yeah, that's the reason. If he plays a5, we don't have a3 because after takes at the end of the variation our rook on a1 is hanging. So that's the reason. After a5 a3 takes, so here here to play c5 and then play first play knight b5 or bishop e3 or c and then c5 and try to do something stuff like this. So after a takes b4, c5, this actually weakens the d6 pawn. So I think here instead of after a takes b4, I think knight hf6 would have been good try. f3, c6, bishop e3, but this is better for white, but still I think this is better than what was played in the game. So after a takes b4, c5 was played, and knight b5, rook b6, knight b5, knight b5 with the aid of that's the reason. Rook a6, bishop e3, and here black played the move knight hf6, but I think c takes b4 was necessary in order to not to allow white create a protected post pawn. Let's see how he does. So after bishop e3, b takes c5, after knight takes e5, bishop takes e5, d takes c5. So now we got a protected post pawn, so that's important thing. So queen e2. Yeah, so this is the start of another mini plan, we should say. So first it cuts off the h5 square. It denies a h5 square to the knight so that it cannot jump to f4 square later. And second thing, he has an idea of playing queen to e3, attacking the c5 pawn. And also, if black tries to play on the queen side on the king side, so queen is better placed on e3. That's the reason. That's overall analysis, I should say. Okay. So. And after queen d7, queen e3, b6, and queen c3, rook a4, rook a1. Yeah, why rook a1? if you see, if you look at the backs, if you look at the black pieces, only the rook on a4 is a very good active piece, and apart from the queen on knight. So that's the reason why we need to exchange our opponent's active pieces. So rook takes, queen takes, king h7, f3. So why f3? Because right now the rook is protecting the e4 pawn. So that's the reason we need to play f3 and free the rook from protecting the e4 pawn. So and also it gives white king an escape square, or it allows to come into game, and also it potentially takes away any g4 square from the knight. So for example, let's say knight to h5 and then knight to f4 and then follow it up with so that's the reason simple f3 takes away all the squares. So that's very good thing. Knight h5, so here g3 is also possible. G3 is also possible, taking away the f4 square, but queen h1 was played, exchanging the queens, I should say. After queen takes h1, knight takes a1, and after knight f4, knight c6. Although the knight looks good, but only on the I don't think it is useful in any way. After knight c6, simple d6 follow with d7 and d8 queen. That's it. That's done. So f6 and g3, knight d3, rook b1, and after rook a8, d6, and black resigned here because there is no way to stop the queen, stop the pawn from promoting to queen. So here, so guys, this is how we need to play. And also one important thing in King's Indian defense is do not try to exchange your light square bishop, because that it's an important piece. It sometimes sacrifices itself for the pawn and h3, or even sometimes it even helps in playing f5, playing f5. So I think the absence of dark square, the absence of light square bishop pawn proved fatal for black here. So that's it, guys. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos, and thank you for watching. Have a good day.